Welcome to the Traveling Bride. In this video, I will be showcasing Coco Reef in Bermuda. This is one of my favorite locations to host ceremonies and receptions because of its views, location, and friendly staff. Let's start in the entrance. This area can be used for cocktail hours or as a backup in case it's raining out. It's huge and can be curtained off. And that's the main front door to the hotel. Check-in desk in the distance, and then also a door that leads out to the guest rooms. And now we'll head over to the bar area. It's great for breakfast, lunch, or dinner. Usually they'll use this if you're using the restaurant Cafe Coco for an event. This would be used for the other guests that are staying at the hotel. Wonderful views from here. We will now walk over to Cafe Coco. I've used this location for private receptions. You can do either really large events here or have both your dance floor, cocktail hour, and reception in here. I'll go ahead and show you a picture of what it looks like. This was set up for about 36 guests with a cake in the middle. Then we had cocktail hour on the raised area just before that with a DJ. Off both sides of the restaurant, you'll notice that there are two smaller areas where we could either seat guests or put buffet stations. That middle area there, that was used for the dance floor that one time with a DJ in the corner. And then dinner was off in the distance where the scaffolding is right now. Let's take a closer look at the buffet stations. And let's head outside now. Outside, we can do just about anything. This is the great thing about this resort. I'm going to show you a picture of a cocktail hour that we had set up by the pool. And aside from this, we also had a bar, open bar, set up right below here. And then a DJ, appetizers in that half moon area to enjoy the view. And it was a little bit later at night, which is nice. That there is the walkway down to the beach. This half moon area is called High Point. This can accommodate 40 for a seated dinner, 75 standing, or you can use it with a DJ for dancing. Under the covered area is Tamara's Terrace. This location can seat around 120 people for dinner. Amazing views from here. I've also used this location when the weather does not cooperate. It's raining out, and I can put a whole wedding ceremony underneath this covered area, and they could still be outside, enjoy the views, but not get wet. I'll go ahead and show you a picture of what it looks like when we set up a hookah and chairs. We had about 35 people in this wedding here, and it worked out really well for the bride. She still wanted to be outside, but we couldn't be on the beach due to the wind and the rain. On the side here, you could use that for a bar setup or a buffet, just to make sure you maximize your use of Tamara's Terrace. Or you can come up here and hold a smaller ceremony up top. The views here, I mean the views anywhere up here are amazing. Take a swing around so that you can see. And then we will head out to this walkway here, which is on the side of where we just were. You can use this for golf carts in case there's anyone that has issues walking distances. That golf cart can get them right down to the grass for a wedding or down to that walkway to get to the beach. We're still inside of that half moon area. It's rather large. Let's head on down to the beach for a closer look. So we're headed towards the alternate path that you can take with the golf cart. You can see one running around in the background. Here's just a little peek. Looking up, those are the guest rooms all on the left here. And in the distance is Westcliff Lawn. We will get to that in just a moment. This here is a beautiful spot for brides and grooms to take pictures after the ceremony is over. Just want to note that this is January in Bermuda, so the sand and the water is up. The water's up further than it normally is, and the sand has been washed out. During the summertime, that fills right back up with sand. To the right, you're going to see Westcliff Lawn. We can hold some really large events over there. And on the left, you'll see Upper Beach. In this area, we can seat about 70, but a group of 40 would probably be a little bit better. We can fit large groups here for ceremonies. You're on the sand, but not on the water, so you don't have to worry about the tide. And once we swing back around, normally the sand is up over most of these rocks. Let's head over to Westcliff Lawn. Here are a couple of the beachfront guest rooms, oceanfront. We're going to walk over to Westcliff Lawn, where we can set up some really large ceremonies here. If you've got over 70, 80 people, we can easily seat them here. And again, you're close to the beach, the sand, but you're not right in it, so it's a little bit easier to walk on. We can also set up a cocktail hour down here. When you're using this location, there's really not much more you need. You can just use your chairs. The bride will have some flowers, and that's really all you need. I'll go ahead and show you a picture of what that looks like. And, you know, use the space that you have. The views are amazing. And that's Elbow Beach in front of this hotel. I'll go ahead and show you a ceremony that was set up for 30 guests. As you can see, the chairs are just enough. You can add more to it, but I'm a fan of the simple ceremony, and this looked gorgeous in their pictures. You can also set up a ceremony just below this little ridge here on the sand. So here's that small ceremony set up on the beach. Gorgeous spot. We were going to put up a hoopah, but the wind was blowing a little too hard. So this pretty much wraps up our tour of Coco Reef. If you want any more information, please feel free to go to my website, thetravelingbride.com, or you can email me at gigi@thetravelingbride.com. Be alright.